start with chapter 7. I'm going to walk around and check out to see what awesome facts you found, what words you didn't know, and the questions that you might have that you wrote down on your sticky notes already because you read it last night. Okay? So go ahead and start sharing with your partner. I will give you 10 minutes to do this. Find your facts in your last two chapters. We're going to move on, so you don't need your book for these ones. So you put it in the corner of your desk. Okay, so on Monday, we talked about our argument, right? Do you believe to be true or not true? So, we're going to move on from that, and we're also going to be talking today about our noun or argument. I know you guys talked about that on Tuesday. I'm still kind of right there. You're going to talk to somebody else when I'm right here speaking? Okay. So, today, up on the board, we have something that's going to guide us through a research-based argument essay. And this is how an argumentative essay starts. It starts with an argument, right? So, Antonio, can you read the blue writing on that, please? But we'll wait to make sure everyone is listening first. By removing their judgment and gathering evidence to support both sides. So, when you guys make an argument about something, you can't just fight the one side that you believe. You have to be able to show that the other side of the argument doesn't make sense or that they're wrong. So it's like if you guys have a fight with a sibling or even your parents, but you say to them, you want to go to your friend's house after school, and your parents say, no, your homework's not done, you can't go. How would you prove them wrong? You show them that your homework's done, right? You could study over there. That's a great point. Talking about an argumentative essay, I can study over there, my homework's already done. That's your counter argument. Because that's your argument that you came back at them with and said, oh no, okay, let me prove to you why my argument is right. Okay, so what we're going to do right now, does everyone have a blue sticky note and a pink sticky note? Everyone needs to make an argument for why it should not be served at school.
A.
So we have to do both?
You have to do both.
Why?
Because what I want you to figure out is if whatever you believe, do that one first. So if you believe soda should be served at school, do the pink one first. And then I need you to make an argument that the other side would say.
Okay.
Okay. If you believe soda should not be served at school, then do that one first. Do your blue sticky now. Get that, make that a really strong argument. And then, yeah, blue is for against, pink is for. Then I want you to make an argument for what the other side might say to you so that you're ready to battle it. So
wait,
it comes at you.
We know?
Hold on. Go ahead, Ashton. Okay. Sorry.
If you would say like that you don't want soda to be served at school, would you say?
You have to tell me
why. Pink one first?
No. If you don't want soda to be served at school, do the blue one first.
Oh, you would say that.
Yeah. Yes, Gabriel.
So you can do it.
Okay.
And then the other one would be what other people
okay. Want.
I don't
have a paint marker. So the blue and the red one. Your blue sticky note is for why soda should not be served at school. You need to make an argument for it. If that's your first belief, just give me an argument. Just give me one statement. Why it should not be served at school. You can if you want, but you're only going to get
2 minutes.
7 minutes. If you believe soda should be served at school, do the pink one first. A one statement argument. Okay? And after you make your first argument, you need to do the other side. You gotta understand what the other side might say to you so you're ready with a rebuttal.
What?
A rebuttal? We'll talk about that
before.
Once you're done with your first argument, make sure you do the argument of the other side. What might the other side say to you to tell you that you're wrong?
The other side might say
no. Arguments. But here's something that I'm walking around kind of looking. Make sure you're coming up with an argument that can be fought. You can't just go to someone and say, well, I like soda, so it should be served at school. No one's going to believe you.
Yeah.
If you went to the principal right now and said, hey, I really like soda, let's serve it at school, she would be like, go back to class and don't talk to me. She's not even going to listen to you. You got to come up with a really good argument. You have to come up with a really good argument. Maybe if nobody drinks the milk, soda would make this money more school. It would make the school more milk. That's a great argument to come to someone with. Should it be served at school?
Should it be served
at school? sugar than juice or lemonade.
Milk? Nope.
So, we find milk. Then, I want you, arguing your side, I want you to try and defend yourself. See if you can't come up with another argument. Okay? I'm going to give you guys 5 minutes to have your mini argument with your partner.
So, I'm saying yes. Soda shouldn't be.
Bye. Understand the other side of the argument. So if you're writing that humans are the cause of global warming, you have to understand and be open-minded enough to the fact that others believe humans are not the cause of global warming. Okay, so you have to be able to find the arguments of the other side that make sense. But then, someone by the number of 21.
What?
You're going to read number 2 on writing. He's going to read number 2. Go ahead.
The turn back is a return to the original argument. Be sure to repeat the same thing.
Good. Okay, so now you've been open-minded enough to see the other side. And you understood their argument. And you stayed their argument. But now you need a turn back. Or, I used this word earlier, we were a little confused, a rebuttal, which is something that is going to return to your argument that you are trying to make, and at the same time, oppose the other side's argument. Okay? So on here, so the other side's argument can also be known as the counterclaim. We talked about that with this one. You guys made a counterclaim to your original argument about why soda should or should not be served at school, and then you guys made a counterclaim for it. So a rebuttal or a turn back is a reason why the counterclaim is not as strong as the original claim. Do we understand this?
Yeah.
Good. Okay. So what I want you guys to do now, on the back of your paper, so go ahead and turn it over. Okay. Once you guys can show me that you made an argument for, okay? So this is my argument. Pizza is better than cheeseburgers. Last thought. Put them in the corner of your desk, and then we'll go line up for PE. y'all. Have a good day.